Okay. Next up is Nicki Minaj Truffle Butter. This isn't her first reaction. No, it's not. I've heard it before, but in this shit dropped, I'm pretty sure, because I feel like a lot of people were bumping this song. I definitely heard it a few times, but the last time I heard it was probably when it dropped. So it's been a long minute. I don't remember anything. I never actually dissected the lyrics. And I want to explain my hate for Drake. I got people asking, you hate Drake, huh? Like, as if someone can't dislike someone or hate them. You can skip this if you don't give a fuck, but I don't like Drake for three reasons. The original reason that I didn't like Drake for, that, like, started my disappointment with him, was when he came at Kid Cudi. Kid Cudi legit made a huge-ass post, man, saying how, like, he's dealing with all these suicidal thoughts, man, and he's tired of it. He was struggling. He really went into depth about how he needed help, and he's going into rehab. And he went into rehab and shit. And while he was in rehab, Drake dropped a diss track saying he was just going through his phases, which it was clever in a sense that the moon, Kid Cudi's known for being on the moon series, and the moon has its own phases. And he was just saying that he was just going through phases and shit. And it just seemed like he was dismissing his mental health, saying that, you know, his depression and suicidal thoughts, it's just, he's dismissing it. He's invalidating that shit. And I was just super disappointed. I don't know. It really pissed me off, man. Because, like, you don't come at a guy that's already at his fucking lowest and kick him even more. If it was a different rapper, it wouldn't have mattered that much. But since it was Drake, one of the most famous fucking artists out there, saying this shit, it's like, dude, know your place. Know your fucking privilege. You're one of the biggest fucking artists. How the fuck are you going to come at this motherfucker? I don't know. Okay, I don't want to keep going on about the Kid Cudi part. But that shit, that started it all. And then that video started getting famous, the one video where Drake was on stage, second reason, when he was on stage when he was 23, I believe he was 23, and he kissed this girl that was 17, and then when she told him her age, he's like, why you look like that, you thick, and he was saying stuff like, fuck, what did he say? It was super fucking creepy, dude. It was super fucking creepy. I don't give a shit, man. It was creepy as fuck. Like, even after she said her age, he was still, you know, like, kind of flirting with her. And then the Millie Bobby Brown thing. The motherfucker's in his 30s texting a 14-year-old kid about boy advice, giving advice on boys. And she was saying, like, Drake's my best friend. She was, like, saying they text so often that she's best friends with them, which is super fucking weird. I don't give a fuck that they're both celebrities, all right? They're both human beings like everyone else. Motherfucker's 30 years old texting a 14-year-old. No, dude, I can't. Drake's just so fucking sus, dude. Not only that, but, like, his attitude and behavior, who knows if it's a front? His attitude and behavior so douchey and fuckboy. Motherfucker has a child. He has a baby mama and a kid, and he's still got this fuckboy vibe. No, I don't like Drake, man. And if you're upset that someone else doesn't like Drake, then you should consider, like, open your fucking mind. Not everyone's gonna love that artist, all right? Not a lot of people, like, especially someone like Drake. There's a lot of hate for Drake, all right? So fuck Drake. I don't give a fuck about the guy, but I can't deny his craft. He's good at rapping, and he has some good songs. He has a lot of good songs. Besides Certified Lover Boy, that shit was so generic, dude. There's like two good songs on that album, and I couldn't. The album was trash. But Views is legendary. You can go back to his older stuff. A lot of his, still, I hate Drake with a fucking passion, but I do appreciate his music. I do like his music, not all of it, but he has a lot of good music. I'm not denying that. But he's still a fucking douchebag, creepy fucking loser. So fuck Drake. It will always be forever fuck Drake. Anyways, Truffle Butter, sorry for the little rant. I just saw a lot of comments like, yo, you hate Drake. Yes, I fucking hate Drake, and I thought I should explain myself because I fucking hate the guy. Anyways, onwards with the song. Hopefully y'all skipped if you didn't want to hear that rant. If not, I told you to fucking skip. Don't complain about me ranting. I told you to skip, bitch. I fucking told y'all, alright? This is a classic beat, isn't it? This is a classic beat. Or sample.
Thinking out loud. I must have a quarter million on me right now. Hard to make a song about something other than the money. Things I'm about to.
I'm glad he could admit that, because a lot of times his songs are legit, like, flexing money and shit.
Have a quarter million on me right now. Hard to make a song about something other than the money. Two things I'm about to talk and blunt and staying blunt and pretty women.
Hey.
Now you're here.
all your hair right now, huh? We should all disappear right now. Look, you're getting all your friends and you're getting in the car and you're coming to the house. Are we clear right now, huh?
Uh-huh.
You see the fleet, all the new things. Cop cars with the loose change.
Did he just say it's pretty? What did he say at the start? Hard to make a song about something other than the money. And he goes on to say cop cars with loose change. He's pretty much just saying like he can buy cars with like a fucking what would be a dollar to us. You know what I mean? Like, can he not like spit a whole verse without like mentioning superficial things like cars and women and stuff? I don't know.
All white like a Mustang. Niggas see me rolling in they mood change.
It's
like
cocaine.
New floor, I got a dozen of them. I don't trust you, you are undercover. I could probably make some steps, sisters fuck each other.
See what I mean, dude? This guy's a huge fuckboy, bro.
Talking fillets with the truffle butter. Fresh sheets and towels, man, she gotta love it. Yeah, they all get what they desire from it. What? Tell them niggas we ain't hiding from it.
When I hear truffle butter, I'm pretty sure there's like a different term for it. Isn't truffle butter an actual like high class food or something? Or is it? Because I know there's like this dirty sexual term for truffle butter, but isn't there also like an actual like, you know, food of truffle butter? Or am I tripping? But what else did he say? Fresh sheets of talisman, she gotta love it. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Not bad. It was a good verse. The Stuff Sisters part, Jesus Christ. But this beat, what's up with the beat and the sample? Is this like the original track? Because I know this beat and I know the sample, but I don't know if this is the track that I know it from. I don't know. It's a dope beat. Or maybe not, it is a sample right here. Yeah, it's an electronic track. So it's a sample. Here we go, Nicki time.
Yo, thinking out loud, I must have about a milli on me right now.
Pause, wait, what did Drake say? He said quarter mil? Yeah, he must have a quarter million on me right now. And what she saying? She got a milli? Yo, what's Wayne gonna say? I don't wanna scroll past. I wanna wait, but what's Wayne gonna say? He's gonna say a couple milli. I must have about a milli. He's gonna be like, I got a couple milli. We'll see.
Yo, thinking out loud, I must have about a milli on me right now. And I ain't talking about that Lil Wayne record. I'm still a highest selling female rapper for the record.
She already beat Drake. She already beat Drake, dude. She already beat Drake with the verse, dude. And I ain't talking about that Lil Wayne record. A milli. Oh, that's so hard, bro. Yo, dude. Bro, oh my god.
Now, and I ain't talking about that Lil Wayne record. I'm still a highest selling female rapper for the record. Man, this is 65 million single soul. I ain't gotta compete with a single soul. I'm good with the ballpoint game, finger roll. Ask me how to do it, I don't tell a single soul. Pretty women, what's up? Is your hair right now? You a stand up or is you in your chair right now?
Bro, okay. Oh my goodness. I love this is 65 million singles sold, and it just sounds so similar to single soul. I gotta compete with the singers, dude. The bars and the wordplay, it's so fucking good, dude. Finger roll like in basketball, dude. Oh my goodness, it's so smooth, it's so well made.
Pretty women, what's up? Is your hair
single
right
soul?
Now? Stand up or is you in your chair right now? Do you hear me? I can't let a whack nigga get near me.
Drink.
Bitch, you damn it. I ain't never need a man to take care of me. Yo, I'm in that big boy. Bitch.
That's a yo Drake reference, right? It doesn't say it in here, dude. I clicked on the lyrics. It doesn't reference the Drake reference. That's clearly a Drake reference. You guys don't see when the definition or the explanation when I click it because the screen's cut off, but. She say, da-da-da, I ain't never need a man to take care of me. The take care part, dude, is that not, that's gotta be like, you know, a double entendre or whatever in the sense of Drake, his album, Take Care.
If you damn it, I ain't never need a man to take care of me. Yo, I'm in that big boy, bitches can't rent this. I floss every day, but I ain't a dentist. Your whole style and approach, I invented. And I ain't taking that back, cause I meant it.
Bro. Man, oh, you hear the classic lighter. Classic lighter.
Thinking out loud, I could be broken, keep a million dollar smile.
I love Lil Wayne, bro. Yeah, I love Lil Wayne, how he did that. Instead of keeping up with the same kind of style I have about a whatever on me right now, kind of like saying how much money they have on them right now. He said he could be broke and keep $1 million smile because he's worth $1 million himself. You know, he just got millions in his pocket. He's worth $1 million, or not even that. His smile is only worth $1 million. You know what I mean? Like, that's Lil Wayne, bro. Lil Wayne, man. Sometimes his verse is lax, sometimes, dude, but sometimes, like, when he actually tries to be lyrical, it's so good. Like, a lot of times, it's like, I feel like Lil Wayne doesn't always try to be lyrical a lot. You know, like, he'll do whatever he feels, which is cool, but I love when Lil Wayne gets into his lyrical side.
LOL to the bank, checking my account. Loud, I could be broke and keep $1 million smile. LOL to the bank, checking my account. Bank teller flirting after checking my account. Pretty ladies, are you here? Truffle butter on your pussy. Cuddle buddies on the low, you ain't gotta tell your friend.
Truffle butter, yeah. See, the Urban Dictionary definition, for those of you that don't know, this is gonna be gross. Just a heads up, skip ahead like 15 seconds, 30 seconds. As a mixture of bodily fluids resulting from anal and vaginal sex. So, like, you, yeah. Let me, he makes the most sexual reference. Yep. What is this? Wait. There's a quote here. Lil Wayne, who makes the most sexual truffle butter reference, told GQ, "I thought truffle butter was something you put on your steak or food. So I was saying, like, I ate a lot of pussy and I'm going to put that sauce on, you know." I don't know. So he didn't know. Oh my God. When he wrote this, he didn't know what truffle butter was, dude. Fuck, where did it go? He didn't know what it was. No shot. He didn't realize the double entendre. That's what I said, though. It was a food, right? There is a truffle butter food, or is there not? Lil Wayne thought it was a food, so if Lil Wayne thinks it's a food, it's okay for me to think that. But damn.
Yeah, truffle butter on your pussy. Cuddle buddies on the low. You ain't gotta tell your friend that I eat it in the morning. Cause she gonna say I know. Can I hit it in the bathroom? Put your hands on the toilet. I put one leg on the tub, girl. This my new dance move. I just don't know what to call it. But bitch, you dance.
Bro, that's the new dance move, because, you know, oh my God, he explained what he's doing. He's banging in the bathroom, and he's putting a leg up while he's, you know, like, he's trying to get in there. He's trying to get the optimal angle, and he calls it a dance move. Yo.
Dancing with the leg on the tub, girl, this my new dance move. I just don't know what to call it, but bitch, you dancing with the stars. I ain't nothing like your last dude. What's his name? Not important.
That's I bought the stars. Cocaine,
it's not air. She became a vacuum. Put it on my dick like carpet. Suck the white on white chocolate. I'm so heartless, thoughtless, lawless, and flawless, smallest, regardless, largest, and charging, born in New Orleans. Get killed for Jordan, skateboard, I'm gnarly, Drake, Tunch, and Barbie. You.
Bro, so this part right here where he said, "I'm so heartless, thoughtless, lawless, and flawless, smallest, regardless, largest, in charge." That part, I was like, when I heard that, like, it sounds cool, but, like, literally anyone can go on, what's that one website called? Rap Dictionary or some shit like that? And you literally, Rhyme Zone. There's a lot of rappers do use that, which is crazy. And they can literally just write, you know, all the rhymes together. Like, it was so basic. But where the good part came in was the second half where he continued the rhymes, but with more context rather than just saying words that rhyme. And it, I don't know, because, like, if he just left this first part here and didn't add in the second part, I would have been disappointed. Because, like, sure, it rhymes, but for what purpose? And the second part is the purpose for why it rhymes. Man. This should be a first reaction. Like, I don't even remember this song. I think I should just name it First Reaction. I don't remember the song, dude. I never digged into the lyrics. This is pretty much new to me. I do remember the sample, but I don't think I remember it from this song. That was a sick ass track. And Drake, so the verses, I'd pick Nicki first. She definitely, no question, dude, no question. Lil Wayne's verse, I definitely enjoyed more than Drake's, but Drake, I can't deny, he had a good verse as well, but his verse felt more vibey, I guess to say, more laid back, you know, and then Lil Wayne, and then Nicki, you know what I mean? Like, okay, that's actually backwards the way I said it. I said it right. Nicki, Lil Wayne, then Drake. That's the order I think the verses go. Dope ass track, clean sample. I love that sample, dude. They all killed it. This one passes for sure. I'm gonna give this one a 9.1. It was a dope track. 9.1.